What's up, everybody? Pal702 back today with a single coil RDA review. This right here is the Entheon by PSYCLONE MODS. Yeah, that's what it comes in. So, Entheon by PSYCLONE MODS, you guys probably heard of it. If you haven't heard of it, it's on the like higher end scale of single coil atomizers. So what we are going to do is we are going to go downtown, get a closer look at this guy right here. Tons of accessories to go through, and then we're gonna throw a build in her and pop back up for pros, cons, all that good stuff. You know how we do it. Entheon by PSYCLONE MODS. Since there's not really a box to go over, they did manage to get this little cute card on there. As you can see, we have the do not vape while pregnant. No 18, no 21. Man, you gotta make no 21, no 18. I figure 18's enough, but hey, I guess there's different laws in different states. You have, you should recycle always. You have the C and the E, and then once again, do not throw your garbage in the trash. This is designed in the USA, made in China. So, it comes in this nice little pouch, and if you notice the front right here, it's like a face, I guess. You got like a face going on, and then this looks like some type of an engine, you know, that looks like the head's like on a motorcycle with like the heat fins on it, maybe like a spark plug going in the back of their head. It's kind of trippy. Like, it's kind of cool though. It's just a little bag. I mean, it comes with a lot of stuff. So we're gonna look at that stuff. Well, first let's do it like this. Yeah, it comes with that much stuff. Nice little baggie though, by the way. I mean, you kind of need it to keep all the extras that comes with it, but if you wanted to put those somewhere else, this is like, I don't know if it's like neoprene or something, but nice, very nice. All right, let's take her one by one. First piece, first accessory, you have a stainless steel beauty ring. I guess I'll just take these out. Okay, so right here, we have a stainless steel beauty ring. The Entheon itself is 22 millimeters. So a lot of times people will use these beauty rings to kind of fill out the space on top of their mod. You know, it just makes it look better on the mod. You know, you don't have to use this. There's no real, you know, it doesn't make it vape any better. Just kind of for looks. Up next in the accessory pile, you have a stainless steel wide bore tip and a Delrin. As you can tell though, the Delrin actually has a smaller circumference inside of there. It's more restricted. It's still considered a wide bore per PSYCLONE, but you can tell that the stainless steel is clearly a larger bore. This goes down significantly compared to that one. And you have your 510 stainless steel. Oops. So you have your 510 stainless steel Delrin. Bottom of the stainless steel has like some O-ring action on it. And this one, yeah, has some O-ring action on it. So, stainless steel, Delrin, here we go. You have your 510 drip tip adapters. So you can either choose, once again, your stainless steel or your Delrin, and then you can make this dripper use your own 510 if you wish. And in your last peripheral bag, you have a shitload of O-rings. You have your 510 if you don't want to squonk it, and then you have an extra clamp. This does use these pretty cool little clamps in order to install your coils. Here is the Entheon by Psyclone Mods. You can see there's no design or anything on it whatsoever. It has, you know, just two airflows, one on this side, identical one on this side. It has kind of this reduced chamber cap going on. This is just wide open with no, obviously no drip tip or anything. You know, that's what it looks like straight down the barrel. Underneath, you have Psyclone, Entheon, 2017. And then this design, it appears to be like an angry robot with a squonk pin coming out of his mouth. Yeah, pretty cool though how they etched that on there like that. And this is the inside of the Entheon cap with the wide bore stainless steel tip in, but you can see how the top of this, how it's not really rounded like conical, but it kind of is that reduced chamber. You know, it's got a clear kind of edge to it. There's kind of an edge, you can see angle in. But very, very good machining. You can see on this machining, this is very beautiful. Stainless steel 316L. Very nice. And if you can see the airflow, it does have an angle going down. You got an airflow slot right there and another one on the other side. So it comes in from up top, comes in from here, and then it splits to here and here. And that is for squonking. You're gonna have to really, really squonk the shit out of this to get this thing to leak. So awesome. Before we turn it around and have a good look at the deck, you'll also notice that there is dual O-rings right here. And this is, once again, a 22 millimeter deck. And there you have the deck of the Entheon. So just starting out, you see over here, that is your positive, that's your peak insulator right there. So there's your positive post. There is your negative post. Your leads, the way I do it, you see how this clamp, it angles down on this side and then angle down on this side. This is what I use to clamp my leads. Now these clamps, just before I forget, I'm gonna do this right now. Otherwise I swear to God I'll forget. So we're doing it now. You'll notice that they move. Now, depending on which way that you've wound your coil, clockwise or counterclockwise, you may have to switch these, but do not spin them around. Move this one to this side and this one to this side. As you can see, yeah, so that cutout right there, if you were to put that on that side, you get this over, other side over here that's bowed out. So it's not designed to be spun around. It's actually designed to move this guy over there and that guy over there. Still very cool though, because you guys know sometimes when you're, you know, you might buy coils or you might wind coils and you go to put it in the RDA and you're like, shit, and now I gotta go either find, you know, counterclockwise wound coils, or I gotta wind it counterclockwise, because I'm always used to just winding them clockwise. So with this, it doesn't really matter which way you wind them or which way you buy them. You can just switch these posts right here. You can see for a little guy, this has a very deep well. So when you're looking way, way down there, I don't know if I can get in there to see the squonk hole. When you squonk it, it's gonna come out of this side at the bottom of the center block and this side at the bottom of the center block. When we get this thing on top of a squonk, I'll go ahead and do it before I put a coil in here so you can actually see how it squonks, but it's pretty cool. You actually have a pretty massive juice well in such a little small little deck like this. That's the deck, you know. You got your little squonk hole, nice little deep juice well, you know, switchable clamps, you know, big pro as far as which way you wound your coils. And then to me, probably the best thing about this RDA is how they did the airflow. I really like how, you know, you basically have all of this right here. That is your juice well. You have to squonk a shitload in order for air to come out of this. Now, let's just try some of these options on here. You get a bag full of peripherals, so let's just, you know, let's try everything out. Wide bore drip tip, stainless steel. Eh? Hmm? Notice there's like a little bit of a space right here. That is not like an error in machining. I believe that's to dissipate heat. Beauty ring. Look at that. Look at that. That right there, that is Lord Stanley's Cup. Right there. You win the whole thing in the NHL. Very similar. That's a whole lot of steps going on right there. You're either gonna really think that's pretty or you're gonna kinda, yeah. Okay. And then you have stainless steel 510. Once again, notice the space right there on the drip tip. That is supposed to be like that for heat dissipation. Delrin 510 with 510 adapter. Once again, with the space that is not, you know, an error or machining anything. That's just the way that it sits. And Delrin wide bore drip tip. Although, once again, the wide bore is not so wide compared to the stainless steel. But there she is. And after you put all your accessories on, if you are into selling any type of illegal substance where you need a dime bag, you're in luck. All right, so since we are down here, we are going to throw that clean as fuck coil into that clean as fuck RDA. Come back up, have some vapes. Hit it. And that was the Entheon by Psyclone Mods. As you can see, we decided to go classy on this one. We put her on top of the SQ. This is by SQ, this Signature Mods. It's got the custom doors on there, if you will. Very nice. Very nice. Elegant looking. So yeah, how's she vape? Almost got a ring. All right, so pros, cons on the Entheon. To me, the Entheon, you know, I've put a bunch of different builds in there. I've had round wire, I've had, you know, fused and tries and quads and aliens and all that stuff. And the flavor is good. It's good flavor, but kind of my standard is kind of the B2K. I'm kind of partial to that. I feel like the B2K has more flavor than this does. It has much better airflow. I mean, this is a restrictive airflow and it's supposed to be, and I understand that, but it's a little bit on the turbulent side, but still you do get good flavor. You do get good flavor from this, but not kind of the flavor that I was expecting for almost $100 after your shipping and all that stuff like that. So on the flavor, it's just good. It's not, you know, I'm gonna write home about it or, you know, call somebody and tell them all about it on the phone. You know, it's good. It's not bad, it's just good. The clamp system, if you guys saw, it's really kind of finicky. And if you're not careful on certain wires, those are really, really easy to bend. You know, and I don't torque stuff down hard at all, but I can see those things flexing. And I imagine if someone's had these for a while, you know, you're gonna need that extra one. At least they give you an extra one in there, but I could see, you know, if I was to vape this thing for the next like 2 years and come back to you guys, I would definitely probably have went through at least one of those. So, you know, the clamp style on that, in my opinion, it's not my favorite, but it is easy to put, you know, it is easy to put coils in. So those are kind of my two kind of cons. Yeah, I'm just not a big fan of them. Pros though, let's go pros. Pros is A, it looks fucking cool. I mean, it's definitely got the high-end look to it. The machining is very, very nice. And you saw the accessories it comes with. You know, the accessories to me, because the vape I get out of it, you know, it's gonna be subjective. There's gonna be other people out there gonna say this thing's got banging flavor and they love it. And I understand that, it's just my opinion. So a pro is on all those accessories. The fact that you get, you know, a couple different drip tips, you know, black and stainless steel, you know, 510 drip tips, 510 adapters, you get a wide bore, like proprietary stainless steel and a Delrin 2 with a little bit different of a bore inside of it. You get the beauty ring, all that stuff. And it's all machined very well. So, you know, they're not far off on the price, you know, that $80, $90 price. It is very, very beautiful. It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful atomizer to me. When you get the beauty ring on there, it's a little too stepped up. But the overall, for me, the thing about this is it just looks gorgeous.
Hey, you guys, look, this isn't gonna be one of my favorite ones. What I don't like about it is it's just kind of subjective. I bet there's a million people out there that say this thing's got the best flavor ever, but I would say that you haven't seen the B2K yet. So for this one, I'm just gonna give this one, is it worth 90 bucks? I would say no if it didn't come with all those accessories. But the fact that it comes with all that stuff and the fact that my vape experience on this is, you know, it's subjective. I don't think the flavor's there, and I've done a different, you know, I've done a lot of builds. I've had this thing for, you know, a few months. I don't know. There's other ones. I think the Wasp gives better flavor. I think B2K gives better flavor. There's a lot of them that I've tried to give better flavor. And that's off of this. Now, if you want to spend more money, you want to drop some more coin, then you can buy these directly from Psyclone Mods. This is like the beauty rings. And then you have stubby caps.
I don't know if that's gonna zoom in.
Yeah, so you can get these. Now, this is where it changes up a little bit. So, I mean, you don't even have to buy the beauty rings, but say you buy the stubby caps. You buy the stubby caps, you're gonna get
like an ultimate one, a white one, a clear one, and then somewhere around here, the black one right here.
So, this is what saves the Entheon, okay? So, 1 second. Game changer alert. So, the stock Entheon cap for me just doesn't really bring the flavor. This cap right here, this, you can buy this, you know, they're all over the place, but I bought it directly from PSYCLONE MODS. As you can see, it's much shorter. So you're getting, you know, far more condensed chamber. Now when you put this thing on, totally different vape for me. This guy right here is, it's a win. I mean, now you're gonna have to go spend another, fuck, like 30 bucks or something. It's like 30, 35 bucks for the cap. But the Entheon with this cap on it, not only does it stay cooler, but the flavor pops way, way, way more. This is the way I've been running it forever on that DS of mine. I had this on top of there and with a single coil on that dual battery mech. I mean, that fucking thing lasted forever. So I really, really enjoy the Entheon with this cap on it. This cap, not so much. This guy, love it. So for what it's worth, if you do choose to buy an Entheon, I would highly, highly suggest going out and you don't have to get the rings. This does have the beauty ring on it. When you get both of these together, you know, it's like after shipping, you're spending another like 50 or 60 bucks probably. Yeah, so you're up in the neighborhood of 140, 150, just saying. But this setup right here totally will rock this setup. Stays cool, way better flavor. I don't know, sounds like the airflow is a little bit quieter on this as well. So, that being said, buy the fucking caps. The cap is where it's at. This is for me. Other people I've heard have loved, you know, the stock one like this, but just didn't do it for me. So, you know, at the end of the day, it is a gorgeous RDA. It's machined beautifully. No argument on my part on that at all. Do I think it's worth all the money? No, not really. But that's also because I didn't think, you know, it vaped. I didn't get a great vape out of the stock cap and all that stuff. You know, I got a good vape, but if I'm gonna drop $100, I'm expecting something a little special. But if you go out and buy the caps, that was the game changer for me. So that being said, we're gonna get out of here, guys. Once again, thank you so much for all of your comments and, you know, just I have fun. I'm having fun with you guys. I look forward to posting these videos and hearing from you guys and hearing your thoughts and stuff. And I'd love to hear what you guys think about the Entheon. My guess is that plenty of you out there have this, so I would love to hear, you know, your guys' thoughts on this. I don't know what else is going on out there in the world right now, but I do know around here, it's all love. We'll catch you on the next one. Buy the caps.